I plan to see President Biden, whom I've known for over 40 years. This will be an opportunity to thank him for the things he did for Israel in the war and during his long and distinguished career in public service as senator, as vice president, and as president. It will also be an opportunity to discuss with him how to advance in the critical months ahead the goals that are important for both our countries: achieving the release of all our hostages, defeating Hamas, confronting the terror axis of Iran and its proxies, and ensuring that all Israel citizens return safely to their homes in the north and in the south. In this time of war and uncertainty, it's important that Israel's enemies know that America and Israel stand together today, tomorrow, and always. I'm leaving this morning on a very important trip to the United States at a time when Israel is fighting on seven fronts and when there's great political uncertainty in Washington. I will address for the fourth time both houses of Congress as the Prime Minister of Israel. I will seek to anchor the bipartisan support that is so important for Israel. And I will tell my friends on both sides of the aisle that regardless who the American people choose as their next president, Israel remains America's indispensable and strong ally in the Middle East.